Yeah, I thought we would have here 5 minutes. So that's of course. I love yourself. Good thing I tell you. So today when on last Saturday when my father transitioned from earth to glory, he actually took his last breath with my head laying in his lap. As a matter of fact, my mother had to tell me that it was time to let him go. Mm-hmm. And so before leaving the hospital of Western Reserve, I was torn within myself because my father and I had the conversation about this meeting today many times. And certainly if anybody planned their own eulogy, he certainly did. And I told the room, I said, my daddy was a man that always called his own shot.
Yes, man.
I used to get tickled listening to my mom and my auntie Punkin telling me that's how my mama fell in love with him. My daddy was, you know, he tells somebody what he's gonna lose on.
That's right. Away. So I thought about Bishop.
Yeah, he's speaking right there. You got the whole fast of things that you learned, even when I go away. When you consider this background here, there are so many things that Jesus should be concerned about in this text. While he's telling us, let not your heart be troubled, I instantly started to think about how Jesus is so cool while he's under all this pressure. I mean, for after all, he's not getting ready to go to a Browns game when he leaves this last summer. Can I keep it real? He's not getting ready to go and celebrate at a ticker tape parade. Amen. He's getting ready to exit that upper room and go to a garden called Gethsemane.
Come on, man.
The place of the crush. And there can be no wall unless there has been a crushing. So he understands that I'm leaving here from this meal, but soon I'll be crushed. So that there can be some more for you.
All right.
He's got every reason for his heart to be troubled. Because when you look at the text, the environment here was taking place. He's in the upper room. He's feeding them the last supper, but he's also beginning to teach them. The Bible says the lesson that he teaches is a lesson in humility and service, showing them how to serve with simplicity. Because how many of y'all know that the apostles and the disciples of Christ really often wondered, who is the greatest among us? That seemed to be the end fight going on, the go on behind the scenes. Who's going to take the place of the Lord when he exits off this earth? Everybody's trying to get in position. And oftentimes, when great men, amen, fall asleep in Jesus, that you will find that there is aftermath of folks scrambling, trying to move themselves into position of power. But Jesus was trying to show them, I'd rather that you be civil in service, amen, rather than to be powerful in an office or a position. Amen. For he says, after all, it's not your position that's going to indicate that you belong to me. Amen. It's not how often that you speak in tongues that's going to prove that you are a part of me. It's not how much tithes you pay. Your name number one on the list every year at the church for what you give is going to indicate that you are a part of me. But he says, by this shall all men know.
Come on.
That thou art my disciples if you have love one for another. So he was trying to teach them a lesson of not only faith, but he's also trying to teach them a lesson of love. And he's so cool, he's so powerful. Let not your heart be troubled, but he really shouldn't be agitated at them because they're trying to position themselves before he even goes away. Yeah, he should be stressed because that word trouble, amen, as it's written here, betray him. So he's at the end of his life and he's still trying to teach, but there are folks around him that are still trying to manipulate and play games. So I oftentimes look at my father and wonder, how do you continue to stay so calm, so cool under pressure? How is it that you can stay so deep within what you're doing, so rooted in what you're doing, that nobody moves you even when you know that they're playing games with you? Says there that Jesus is betrayed by someone whom he deals with.
is soko. Uh-huh. In soko, it means, yes, there's a peace. Uh-huh. But it is a peace that has been broken off. Uh-huh. And why is it that it's folks who betray you? Uh-huh. Amen. It's the folks who you have broken off.
I never broke any sleeves.
After getting broken off, that Judas, the Bible says in verse number 30, he immediately ran out. Uh-huh.